a far-off place lived a handsome prince with a gloomy face, for he did not have a bride. And he searched, alas, and he pined, alas, but alas, the prince couldn't find a lass who would suit his mother's pride. For a princess is a delicate thing, delicate and dainty as a dragonfly's wing. You can recognize a lady by her elegant air, but a genuine princess is exceedingly rare. On a stormy night, to the castle door came the lass the prince had been waiting for. "I'm a princess lost," quoth she. But the queen was cool and remained aloof, and she said, "Perhaps, but she'll need some proof. I'll prepare a test and see. I will test her thus," the old queen said. "I'll put 20 downy mattresses upon her bed, and beneath those 20 mattresses, I'll place one tiny pea. If that pea disturbs her slumber, then a true princess is she." Well, the bed was soft and extremely tall, but the dainty lass didn't sleep at all, and she told them so next day. Said the queen, "My dear, if you felt that pee, then it's proof enough of your royalty. Let the wedding music play." And the people shouted quietly, "Hooray!" For a princess is a delicate thing, delicate and dainty as a dragonfly's wing. You can recognize a lady by her elegant hair, but a genuine princess is exceedingly rare.
There are many versions of this story. I sing them all. This is the prettiest, but it's not quite accurate. I happen to know the true story of the princess and the pea for the very good reason that I was there. It was a small kingdom ruled over by a talkative queen and a mute king. The princess in the true story was not the only girl put to the test. Actually, she was one of 13 girls, girls who came to the kingdom hoping to wed the prince, but who, for one reason or another, were found to be unsuitable. As a matter of fact, the day I arrived at the court, they were testing princess number 12. A curious quiz was in progress.
Oh my goodness, I hope I get this.
Are you ready for your next question?
I guess so.
Your next question concerns famous rulers. Are you quite ready?
Yeah.
Well then, name three kings. Is that clear?
Yes. Would you repeat the question, please?
Certainly. Name three kings.
May I take the third king first? Well then, the three kings are...
Is this a trial?
No.
It's the royalty test to find out if she's a true princess. King John, King Arthur, and...
Does it matter if she's a true princess?
Oh yes. If she's a true princess, we can all get married.
King Ethelred!
That is absolutely correct.
Yes!
She's smart, Mama. She's the best one yet. Can I marry her now, Mama? Can I?
No, sweetheart.
There's still one more question.
This test isn't going to be fair.
It's the law that isn't fair.
Law?
The marriage law.
Throughout the land, no one may wed till Dauntless to the altars led.
Dauntless?
The prince? Until he gets married, none of us can.
Shh. You have now reached the seventh plateau, and this is your final question. The final question is divided into four parts and concerns a famous man often referred to as the Knight of the Red Cross. One, what was his name? Two, what beast did he slay? Three, how many rows of teeth did the beast have? And what kind? And four, what was the middle name of the daughter-in-law of the best friend of the blacksmith who forged a sword that killed the beast?
One, St. George. Two, the dragon. What? Three, they were 12 rows of teeth, and they were iron. Four! Would you repeat the question, please?
What was the middle name of the daughter-in-law of the best friend of the blacksmith who forged a sword that killed the beast?
The middle name?
The middle name.
The daughter-in-law?
In-law. You have 30 seconds.
Okay, I know. This pass, can I have a hint?
Please pass. Do you speak, my lady?
No, I was
20 seconds.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. How many lifelines do I have? It's on the tip of my tongue.
10 seconds.
Oh, can I buy a vowel? Oh, my goodness. I know this.
For a second. Come on.
Okay. It's the name.
I am terribly sorry, but your time is up.
No!
Too bad, my dear, too bad. You do show a certain aptitude, but as for the true brilliance of royalty, I'm afraid not. Remember, blood will tell, and yours didn't tell us quite enough. However, to show that there are no hard feelings, here's a nice consolation prize for you. Goodbye, good luck, and get out! Oh, sweetheart, don't let's stop pouting. Come along. It's nearly time for your cocoa.
Oh, I liked her.
So did I.
Why must every princess get the bird?
It's just absurd.
I've never heard a test so difficult to pass.
Alas, alas, is what I lack. I lack, alas, alas, alack.
Throughout the land, no one may wed till dawn. The share is there. Gentlemen,
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11, 12 contenders in a row. They came, they were tested, then swiftly requested to go.
Trumpets heard like sound of fife.
Tell us when you intend to send us the girls
and get the prince a royal wife. None of the ladies are having any.
No one is getting any younger. And it's been God knows how.
Minstrel, you are just arrived.
Yes, I am, Sir Wizard.
Splendid, splendid. Watch closely. I take a perfectly plain piece of parchment with no cuts, folds, creases, or concealed... What do you want?
Pardon me, Sir Wizard, but I have to take the minstrel to sign in with the castle steward.
This way, please.
I'm heading to Normandy. I won't be staying long.
For your father's sake, I put up with a great deal from you. Just because your father and I were in show business together, don't presume.
As you wish. Cardamon.
Ho, Sir Harry.
My darling, you missed the test.
Sweet Larken, you know my new responsibilities as chivalric knight of the herald. Keep me busy.
The latest princess was a failure.
No.
Yes.
Bad luck. But don't despair, for we have plenty of time. And if a true princess is not found in the next few months, I will go out and find one myself. Or I don't deserve to wear my spurs.
Darling.
My love.
Do you remember the royal joust on Whitsunday when you won those spurs?
Of course.
When you were called Sir Harry, the fairest and bravest knight in all the land, and everyone agreed that you had a brilliant future ahead of you, and that you might someday become Lord Chamberlain, or even Prime Minister.
Well, I don't know about Prime Minister.
Do you remember the picnic we had later on the greensward with the lovely cold pheasant, and you and I wandered away from the others to climb the hill and watch the sun go down?
Yes.
The lark was singing in a tree, and you said you'd remember that moment forever because the lark's song reminded you of my name?
Yes, Larken.
And then you watched the sun go down?
Yes.
Well, I'm going to have a baby. So you see, a princess for Dauntless must be found. And soon, or I shall have to go away somewhere.
Well.
Oh, darling, I'm so worried. This could ruin you. And you'd never be Prime Minister or anything. Oh, just say the word, Harry, and I'll go now. I'll go far away, where they'll never find me. Just say the word.
No, you'll stay here.
Oh, Harry.
We're none of us perfect. Everything's gonna be all right.
Thank you, Harry.
It won't be long, it won't be long, it won't, because it can't be long before our dreams come true. Because you know I don't belong, and furthermore, I shan't belong to anyone but you.
Just a little while, you and I will be 1, 2, 3, 4. In a little while, I will see your smile on the face of my son
to be forever. And in love is the way I have it planned. But I'll only stay in love if the glove contains your hand. November.
My time is at a premium, for soon the world will see me, a maternal bride-to-be. I know I mustn't worry, Harry, still I wish you to hurry, Harry, Harry, marry me.
In a little while, just a little while, you and I will be 1, 2, 3, 4. In a little while, I will see your smile on the face of my son
to be forever. And in love
is the way I have it planned. But I'll only stay in love if the glove contains your hand. I can see it all down to every small detail. So I wish you'd look around until you found a castle in the neighborhood for sale.
darling. Don't dawdle. Dauntless, pick up your feet, for heaven's sake. Oh, and don't squint. I told you not to look at the sun.
Yes, Mama.
That's better. Sextimus, if I've told you once, I have told you 100,000 times, I will not have you running around and playing these foolish games in the hallways. It just isn't dignified. We are the rulers of the kingdom. We must set a proper example for the rest of the court. I mean, what is the point in being a ruler if one doesn't behave as a ruler should?
Mama?
Now what?
Mama, when am I going to get my princess?
Oh, Dauntless, I don't want to talk about that right now. Oh, it's time for your cocoa.
But Mama, sometimes I get the funniest feeling that, well, you don't want me to get married.
Don't want you to get married? Don't want you to get married? Dauntless, don't you trust
me? Well, of course, Mama, but...
Then how can you say such a thing? I want you to get married. How many times have I told you I want you to get married? Only this morning I was saying to your father, I said, Sextimus, I want that boy to get married. It just isn't normal for a boy that age to stay single. Ah! And he is a prince. I said, don't you forget that he is next in line for the throne. I mean, we're not exactly the oldest people in the world, but we're not going to live forever. And I just know that I would feel much better, much easier, much more relaxed in my mind if that boy were married and settled and set. And that is absolutely verbatim exactly what I said to your father this morning. Of course, he didn't say anything. He never does. But you know him just as well as I do. I don't have to tell you how impossible he is. But that's my cross of pain, and I don't want you to worry your head one tiny bit about the fact that your father and I don't get along and never have. If he makes me suffer, if he makes me miserable, I just have to put up with it. And I will not allow it to affect my child's attitude towards him or me. He may be a mean, stupid, dreadful, selfish, rotten man. Oh, but he's your father, and I want you to respect him. Now there's only one person who really cares about you and really worries about your happiness and your health and your future, and that is what I'm talking about, your future. So I want to make myself absolutely clear. I want you to get married, but I don't want you to marry just anyone. After all, marriage is a lifetime partnership, and I wouldn't want to see my little boy make the same mistake I did and wind up miserable the way I did. And you must marry someone suitable, someone who's good enough and nice enough and smart enough for my good, nice, sweet, beautiful baby boy. Oh, you're so cute. Mm. Oh. And she needs to be a princess. I mean a real princess. She has to be a real, genuine, bona fide princess, just as I was. And that's what you want, isn't it? Someone like me? Of course it is. God, if only I were 20 years younger. Oh, just remember this, Dauntless. You must trust me.
Your Majesty, Your Highness.
Hello, Harry.
Oh, don't interrupt. Well,
Sir Harry wishes to speak with you, madam.
Well?
Your Majesty, I have the honor to request a perilous labor. I wish to search for a true princess, a princess of the royal blood. One who will suit both Your Highness and Prince Dauntless.
No.
Mama.
No. We've been through all the eligible girls in all the neighboring kingdoms. There are none left. We'll just have to wait for their little sisters to grow up, and that'll take years.
But Your Majesty, I plan to head north, over the mountains.
Over the mountains.
Across the Badlands.
Across the Badlands.
And into the swamplands where the beautiful Marshley grows.
Marshland, are you out of your mind?
Let him go, Mama, let him go.
Oh, my goodness, you will not find anything there except frogs and tadpoles and things. Do you know what the weather there is like?
Oh, please.
Do you know how damp and foggy and
Mama.
Quiet? No. And how humid and oppressive and
Mama,
sticky and...
Let Sir Harry try. Please, for me, Mama.
Okay. Go ahead. It's your sinus.
Hooray.
No, come along, Dauntless. You've missed your cocoa.
Good luck, Harry. Good luck.
Now, don't be afraid, little Larken. I'll bring back a princess who's not only a true princess, but one who will be able to pass the Queen's test.
I believe you. I'm not afraid.
And I shan't be away long.
Only fly as fast as you can, my love. We shall be waiting for you.
We?
You know. And wear this.
Next to my heart.
In a little while, just a little while, you and I will be wonderfully fond.
In a little while, I will see your smile on the face of my son to be.
Took 3 weeks, and Lady Larken had all but given up hope that he'd find a true princess. Then, one sunny morning in mid-April, when the crocuses were just beginning to dot the meadows, the lookout in the North Round Tower spied two distant figures approaching at full gallop. The alarm was spread. Sir Harry is back! Sir Harry is back with the new princess! Now, how does this part go in the old story? On a stormy night to the castle door came the lass the prince had been waiting for. Ha! That, of course, is utterly untrue. It didn't storm that night at all. In fact, it wasn't even night. And the princess only looked as though she had come in from a storm.
Actually, I swam the moat. But never mind, if I just stand right here, there's a nice draft. I'll be dry in no time.
We try to stop her.
Ew.
Look, Mama. She's all wet.
You swam the moat?
We tried to stop her, but she wouldn't wait for the drawbridge.
You swam the moat?
She seemed determined to arrive as soon as possible.
We had to get a rope and pull her out.
You swam the boat?
All right. I was a little anxious. My friend Sir Harry, he's still out there, told me you had an opening for a princess.
That's the coolest thing I've ever heard.
Any princess. I figured the early bird. Anyway, here I am. Who's the lucky man? Hey, Nani Nani, is it you?
Hey, Nani Nani, Nani, no.
Hey, Nani Nani, is it you?
Hey, Nani Nani, Nani, no.
Hey, Nani Nani, is it you? Or you, or you, or you?
Nani Nani, Nini, Nini, Nuni.
No, no, no!
Someone's being bashful. That's no way to be, not with me. Can't you see that I am just as embarrassed as you, and I can understand your point of view. I've always been shy. I confess that I'm shy. Can't you guess that this confident air is a mask that I wear 'cause I'm shy? And you may be sure, way down deep I'm demure. Though some people I know might deny it, at bottom I'm quiet and pure. I'm aware that it's wrong to be meek as I am. My chances may pass me by. I pretend to be strong, but as weak as I am, all I can do is try. God knows I try, though I'm terribly shy. And despite the impression I give, I confess that I'm living a lie. Because I'm actually terribly timid.
and a horribly shy. No, a lady may be dripping with glamour, as often as not she will stumble and stammer when suddenly confronted with romance. And she's likely to fall on her face when she's finally face to face with a pair of pants. Quite often the lady's not as hard to please as she seems. Quite often she'll settle for something less than the man of her dreams. I'm going fishing for a mate.
She's going fishing for a mate.
I'm gonna look in every brook.
She's gonna look in every brook.
But how much longer must I wait? With bated breath and hook.
Ask her yourself.
Do you ever say anything
else? Do you
else?
Mean to ask me to believe that you are a true princess of the royal blood? Ooh, am I to actually believe that you have the nerve and the gall and the presumption to apply for
Mom, may I say something?
No! Do you imagine for one moment that I would find you suitable for any son of mine?
Well, maybe
you are laboring under a very unfortunate misapprehension, my dear. My son isn't going to marry any moat swimmer. Not while I still have breath in my body. And I haven't been well. Not well at all. I get the shooting pains all through here. And don't tell me it's the vapors. I know what the vapors are. I've had the vapors.
Are you new here?
Oh.
Watch closely. I take a perfectly plain piece of parchment with no cuts, folds, creases, or concealed pockets.
It's a nut house.
No, wait!
You're the one, I guess?
Sure. I'm Prince Dauntless, the Drab.
Oh, well, glad to have met you.
No, please don't go. I like you.
You do.
Everybody does.
No!
Well, almost everybody.
Dauntless, I'd like to stay here, but I wouldn't want to come between you and your mother. So I guess I'll just face the facts, cut my losses, and head back to the swamps.
But I really like you.
You do? Why?
You swam the moat.
Oh, Dauntless, I know I swam the moat, but that's not the real
what?
Me. I'm not like that. Actually, I'm shy!
She's in the moat again! Lower the drawbridge!
Are you all right?
Sure!
You want to see her swim, Mama? She's wonderful!
Yes, isn't she?
It's cold!
I like her, Mama. She swam the moat. Twice.
I don't need any help.
Can I marry her now, Mama? Can I?
Oh, marry her? Of course not! When you get married, no, if you get married, you'll marry a real princess. You'll marry someone who smells much better than you.
I have the honor to announce the arrival of Her Royal Highness, the Princess Winnifred.
You are a little late. She's been here and gone.
Gone?
She's swimming home. That Sir Harry is no princess.
But she is, Your Majesty.
What?
That one? You jest.
On mine honor as a knight, I swear she is. I have her papers right here. Winnifred, Princess of Icolmkill, Guardian of the Midgard Serpent and Warden of the Ragnarok Marshalley. The inscription on her family crest reads, Tu ne cede malis et contra audencio rito.
What does that mean?
Roughly, it means, if at first you don't succeed...
Oh, never mind.
You see, she is a real princess.
She is. Well, I think she is.
At least a test, please, for me, Mama.
Okay. Oh. The wizard and I will put on our thinking caps and think up a nice, fair test, just as we always do, and I will prove to you that this girl cannot possibly be a princess.
Get her by the leg!
This is her leg!
We'll test her for...
That is not my leg!
Oh, how crude. Oh, we'll test her for sensitivity. She'll have her test, and she'll fail like all the others, fair and square.
What test?
The royalty test, Your Majesty?
No. Every princess suing for my hand has to pass some sort of test to prove she's a real princess.
Oh, hmm. Well, what kind of test?
It's always highly secretive. I mean...
Well, we'll worry about that later. For right now, I better get out of this wet dress.
May I show you part of the castle on the way to your room?
Sure.
Well, you're awfully nice.
Well, you're nicer. Well,
and you're good looking, too.
Well, you're better looking and nicer, too.
Well, you're a better swimmer.
Oh, Your Highness, I'm so excited. Sir Harry's back. And he's brought us a sweet princess. Have you seen her? Neither have I. But I'm sure she's as delicate as an orange blossom. And I'm to be her lady-in-waiting. Sir Harry arranged it. Isn't he thoughtful? He arranges everything.
My father expected me to follow in his footsteps, but then I landed this jester job, you know. Your Majesty, what's wrong? You're worried. This is fun. Watch. Oh. What about? Okay. Who? Oh, some girl. A girl. Oh. No, a lady.
Yes.
Which lady? Two syllables. First syllable. A chicken. Or a rooster. No, a bird. Some kind of bird.
A pigeon.
Like an eagle. Ostrich?
No, good one. Good one.
Lark? Lark.
Oh, Lady Larken. Yes.
Small word. But... It, because, that's not even no, small. And.
Oh.
Lady Larken and a fencer. No, a knight. Knight.
Which knight? Who, what?
Do you know what that means? No. I don't know what that means.
Sir Harry.
Sand? Dust. Sounds like dust. Lust.
Must.
Or must, yeah.
Must
sure, whatever.
What? You're gonna start all over again, aren't you?
She's in trouble?
What kind of trouble?
Big trouble.
How many syllables? Oh, no.
She's gonna have a baby?
Whew.
Does anyone else know? Yes, Sir Harry.
Obviously, Sir Harry knows, but does anyone else know?
We can keep a seat, Your Majesty. The question is, can you?
We know you can't talk. You can't talk, but you manage to communicate.
We have only two voices among us, and yet there's a third voice, a voice in disguise. You'll be hearing a trio and not a duet if you listen with both of your eyes. Kindly, with both of your produce a unique and remarkable blend when we raise our three voices on high. We're in perfect accord from beginning to
the king and the minstrel and I.
Yet if one of our trio should ever depart, then the others would languish and die. we're like three different people with only one. The king and the jester and I sing hey, nonny, nonny, hey, nonny, nonny, hi, diddle, diddle, strike up a tune on the... Oh, the bishop declares our behavior is rude as he piously looks to the sky. Cause when we going swimming, we always go the king and the jester,
the king and the minstrel.
Oh, the vintner makes wine from the grapes that he grows. 20 barrels were lost last July. Where they went is a secret that nobody... Oh, the cook claims she's missing one chocolate cream roll and a fish that was ready to fry. Guess who's dining on pastry and filet of... Sing hey, nonny, nonny, hey, nonny, nonny, needle and thimble. Crash us a crash on the... It's been said of our king that his morals are loose, but the queen is much worse on the sly. Cause when we pour the gander, it's good for the...
the king and the jester,
the king and the minstrel.
Papers seem to be in order.
Oh, I know. And the worst part is that the foolish boy actually seems to like the girl. So, we must think of a test that sounds fair, and looks fair, and seems fair, and isn't fair! When you got the idea for testing her for sensitivity, I could have applauded right out loud, but exactly what?
Table manners.
No, that's not good enough. Sensitivity. Sensitivity, sensitivity. I'm just loaded with that. In this one word is the epitome of the aristocrat. Sensitive soul and sensitive stomach, sensitive hands and feet.
This is the blessing.
Also the curse of being the true elite. Common people don't know what exquisite agony is suffered by gentle people like me. Just get your hands off me. Think up a tricky test for that wretched moat-swimming princess.
Madam, may I suggest maybe we ought to...
But don't take all night. I'm not well. I need my rest. Not that I ever sleep on that lumpy mattress. Oh, God, my back! The sensitivity bane of royalty, that bed's a torture rack. Oh, I hate to sound grumpy, but my nerves are so jumpy. I am sure I could feel any lump even if it were under the mattress and small as a pea. That's the answer, under the mattress. We'll test her tonight. One tiny pea beneath one thick downy mattress. Oh God, you're bright. Any genuine princess would feel it if she doesn't, she's through. Get the tiniest pea and order one mattress. No, make it two.
Why not five?
10, I think, would be plenty. better still make it 20. And to play it safe in the event, even that's not enough to ensure that she sleeps, we'll give her a soothing sedative, won't we? You can whip up a drink. Something stunning! Oh, but you're devilish. I love the way you think. She's insensitive, so insensitive, she'll fall asleep, no doubt. God, but you're clever, brilliant, a genius, you are divine! Get out!
Feels good to get into something dry. This old dress is just soaked.
Your Majesty, the King has asked to meet with the young lady.
He did? She never asked before.
He heard she swam the moat.
Oh.
Dauntless, is your father anything like your mother? Because if he is, no. I don't really know.
My father's silent.
Oh, well then I'd love to meet him.
Papa, this is Princess Winnifred.
Your Majesty, the King welcomes you, and he asked me to tell you that he hopes he'll get 100 on the test tomorrow.
Oh, well, thanks.
My father never touches his crown to his heart unless he really means it.
Alas, madam, the King is mute or he would speak for himself. He's still under a curse cast by a witch long ago, before Prince Dauntless was born. The curse says that King Sextimus will never talk until the mouse devours the hawk.
Until the mouse devours the hawk. Well, can't you get a huge hawk and a little mouse and just...
We tried that once, but the mouse got scared and ran away, and the hawk, well bit Daddy.
Oh, well. Just let me get this test under my belt, and we'll figure something out. Don't you worry. It certainly has been a pleasure meeting His Royal Majesty. A short while ago, I had the pleasure of meeting Her Majesty. Ooh, now that's a nice man.
Your Majesty, I think you better speak to Prince Dauntless very soon about, you know.
About what?
Well, your father feels that now that you're old enough to get married, you ought to have a little talk. You know, man to man.
You mean about things? You mean now?
Well, your father says that maybe it would be best to wait until later. There are a few facts he wants to look up first.
Dauntless, I certainly do like almost both your parents.
Well, we want you to be happy here, and we know it's different from what you're used to.
Well, it is a little hard making the adjustment to dry land and everything.
Oh, you must feel like a fish out of water.
As a matter of fact, I do. You see, where I come from, we don't have any dry land. Well, some of the poorer people do, but the nobility live all right in the swamp with their servants and pets.
Oh, do you have any pets?
A lot.
Dogs?
Frogs. I come from the land of the foggy, foggy dew. We're walking through the meadow in the morning is like walking through glitter. The swamps of home are brushed with green and gold at break of day.
At break of day.
The swamps of home are lovely to behold from far away. Thicker.
and I hear the call. The swamps of home, I hear them calling me now, calling me back, calling me Winnifred, 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 Winnifred. Who do you think you are, girl of the swamps? You've gone too far, made of the marshland. Give up the struggle, listen to the voice of the swamp. Lago, lago, lago.
I'd like to lend you something to wear while your garment dries.
Why, thanks.
Ladies.
Dauntless, I have to change now.
Oh, you do? All right.
No, Dauntless. It's bad luck to see too much of the bride before the wedding.
Oh, okay.
Hurry, ladies. May we show you the gowns now, Your Majesty?
Oh, yes.
Now, this is the very latest from Uppley.
Wow.
Lovely work, don't you think?
That's
see?
Real nice.
Notice the fullness in the back and
the window sleeves cut right down to the... It's really you.
You think so?
Marvelous on, don't you think so?
Stunning. Perhaps Your Highness would like to look in the mirror.
Does Your Highness have a favorite color?
Well, back at home we wear a lot of dark green and earth brown. But I guess my own dress there is my favorite color, oxblood. I tell you what, leave them all on the ones I can't use. I'll send back.
Very good, Your Highness. Lady A, Lady M, Lady L, Lady H. Lady R.
Oh, well, this is just real snazzy. Hmm.
Ooh. Ah. Ooh.
I like it. Na 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 na. Oh my goodness. Oh no 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 no. Oh, I can't believe I did this again.
Everything must be spotless for when the princess arrives. I want this room blue. Oh, I guess I won't be needing you, Emily. They've already sent the girl in to do the floors. You're new here, aren't you?
Yes,
well,
I'm...
Well, remember, we all have a job to do, and your job is just as important as anyone else's. Oh, dear, sweet, lovely Princess Winifred, you will pass the Queen's test, you will. Gramercy, my dear. You can't possibly clean the floor with such a tiny patch. What you need is a good, big, wet rag. Oh, here, what's this?
Oh, that's just only my favorite
this
dress.
Here you go. Just look at this mess. What will my gentle princess think of me? Do you know what it means to me to be the lady-in-waiting to the blessed Winifred? Oh, Winifred, Winifred, what name is sweeter than that?
I don't know.
You missed a spot. Just look at this table. It's dripping wet. Here, I'll use this.
Oh, no.
What will my gentle princess think of me? I can't bear to see the delicate beauty of my royal mistress in such a messy place. Oh, get that, please. Yes, you. Quick, quick, quick.
Harry!
Your Highness.
You're get up. You don't have to go through the motions with me. Say, I'm awfully sorry about, you know, swimming the moat.
Hope it didn't make a bad impression.
Not at all, Your Highness. And if you'll just give your wet dress to a lady in waiting, she'll see that it's taken care of.
Thanks. It's already been taken care of.
I see you've met my dear Lady Larken.
You mean this is the little Larken girl?
The very same, Your Highness.
Harry, she's beautiful and a bundle of energy.
When I gaze upon that captivating face, I realize how poor my description must have been.
Sir Harry is not very good at describing people, Your Highness.
Well, he may not know how to describe them, but he sure knows how to pick them. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to return these to the fourth floor.
I've never been so humiliated in my life.
What's the matter?
I thought she was a chambermaid.
What?
A chambermaid.
Larken, how could you mistake the princess for a chambermaid?
How could I? How could you mistake that chambermaid for a princess?
Don't say such a thing. Just because you made a stupid mistake.
I made a mistake? Don't you dare try to blame this on me.
Well, I do blame it on you.
She was on her hands and knees scrubbing the floor.
Well, she's a real lady wherever she was. That's more than I can say for some people around here.
I hate you!
Well, I hate you too.
Get out!
Don't worry, I'm leaving.
Goodbye!
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 Wizard, you should be able to think up something that would make that sleep. Be sure to whip up a sleeping potion and get some of that good heavy incense. And the hypnotic mirror. Oh, but the most important part is that she is tired out first. We'll have an official ball tonight. We'll make that dance until she drops. But what'll we do? Oh, do you know the Saracen Brawl? Yes. No. That's not tiring enough. I have it. We'll do that new dance, the Spanish Panic. It is absolutely exhausting. Do you know it? Well, it is the rage in Venice, everybody. There's to be an official ball tonight, and everyone is to attend! We're doing that new dance, the Spanish Panic. So, the basic step is, ready? Flip your skirts, open, close, right. It's like the magic step, only forwards, just that easy. Let's all try it, yes? 5, 6, 7, 8. What? No! Doesn't anyone here know the Spanish Panic?
We do, Your Majesty.
Well, thank heaven somebody is up to date around here. Why don't we all watch court dancer Sir Harold and Lady Beatrice demonstrate? Lady Beatrice. Now, was that so hard? Suppose we all try it. Take partners. Préparez. Hey! Don't you just love it? Doesn't it make you want to fly?
Are you sure you know what you're doing?
Thank you.
the matter, Your Majesty? You saw a girl and well, you lost her. Don't worry, Your Majesty, I'll help you.
Has he ever had any success?
Well,
I've been here 3 weeks and he hasn't caught that girl yet.
I'll tell you what, tomorrow we'll set a trap.
Oh, you exaggerate.
Not a bit. What's wrong? Someone's coming? Who?
The queen!
And this has to be the biggest, loudest ball we have ever thrown, so be sure to hire extra musicians for tonight's dancing. And tell the jester I want him to perform! Oh, fun! Oh! Not that I will be able to enjoy any of it with my back and that weird nagging pain in my jaw. Oh! God! No one will ever know what I suffer.
What was she jabbering about? She's gonna make us do something?
What?
Exercise? Someone else is coming?
Who?
I don't know. Oh. Lady Larken, is something the matter?
No.
Well, we're glad of that anyway.
I was just in my room sewing, and it got a little stuffy, so I decided to come out here and get some air.
I see you were planning to camp out for a while, huh?
Idea what could happen to the relationship between a man and a woman? I'm glad I found out when I did. It's better this way. I'm leaving.
You're leaving?
Yes, I'm leaving the service of the queen forever.
That's a big step to take all alone.
But I have no choice.
You're leaving forever?
Yes.
You'll need help.
Who would help me?
Oh, I, my lady.
What did you say? You're gonna take care of the Lady Larken. Who's gonna take care of you?
Chivalry demands they protect a damsel in distress.
If you say so, Your Majesty.
But you'll have to travel light, the way a man does.
She'll go as a boy. We can steal one of Prince Dauntless's suits.
Yes.
We'll get these things out of your way.
No, it's okay. I can do this alone.
You want to go over the wall?
Yes, I don't need any help.
Oh, you'll be fine once you get past the water rats.
Rats?
Oh, yeah, they live on the edge of the stagnant pools near the quicksand.
The quicksand?
Oh, and the walls covered with slime.
Slime?
And infested with spiders.
Spiders?
Oh, but the spiders are sweet compared to the snakes.
Snakes? Oh, if I'd known it was so terrible, I wouldn't have wanted to go alone. But then where?
It's April, isn't it? April?
Normandy is fine and fair, so Normandy is where we'll go. I can show you a beach where the peach blossom blows, and I know how to reach a man who knows, a man who knows.
A cozy inn, a friendly place, with rows of windows facing the sea. This time of year, the air I hear is rare and clear and warm in Normandy.
I know a meadow covered with mustard flowers, golden as the sun, where a wondrous thing can happen when an April day is done. There's a moment after the sunset when the sky is suddenly green and the world stands hushed and waiting for the first white stars to convene. When you see that emerald sky, you'll know the reason why. There's not another place I'd rather be.
Keep your Eldorado,
and to hell with Burgundy. Come fly with me.
Come try these wings.
Come swift, for we have things to do.
Is there truly a beach where the peach blossom blows? Are you sure you can reach
let the queen catch you walking.
Have you seen Sir Harry? He's had a fight with Lady Larken. Hey, look.
He's with that French girl. She only speaks a word of English, but I hear she's a real charmer.
What's the one word?
Yes!
How you doing, Harry, old boy?
Très bien.
Well, never mind this. After this, we'll have a little party on the west parapet. And don't forget to bring the wine.
And something to spread on the ground for a picnic.
Harry, ask Mabel if she'd like to bring something.
No, stop.
Mabel, voulez-vous...
Yes!
Clue, huh?
I know it's highly secret, but what sort of test does she usually give?
Oh, well, with Mama thinking up the test, it could be almost anything.
Like what?
Well, sometimes it's history.
Oh.
Or sometimes it's dancing.
Oh, mm-hmm.
Or sometimes it's spelling.
No.
Or could be Oh, the test of strength.
Oh!
For instance, Mama had one of the girls lift this weight. She couldn't. I can't even. But I'm sure you'll pass. You don't have to worry.
Do you want me to pass? Oh, I'll pass.
Wow, I think you're wonderful.
By the way, I don't think I ever told you. My full name is Winnifred the Woebegone. But Winnifred's a little too formal. You can call me by my nickname.
Winnie?
Fred.
Fred. What a beautiful name. Oh. So straight. Oh. So strong. So you. I like you, Fred. I like you.
You're just saying those words to be kind.
No, I mean it. I like...
I mean, I love you, Fred.
He is out of his medieval mind.
I'm perfectly sane and sound. I've never felt better in my life. Everybody, everybody, everybody come and meet my incipient wife. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. My reasons must be clear. When she shows you all how strong she is, you'll stand right up and cheer.
With an F and an R and an E and a D and an F-R-E-D, Fred, yeah.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She drinks just like a lord. So come sing a merry drinking song and let the wine be poured.
Fill a bowl to overflowing, praising all the time. With an F and an R and an E and a D and an F-R-E-D, Fred.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She sings just like a bird. You'll be left completely speechless when her gentle voice is heard.
Fill the bowl to overflowing, praise the goblet high. With an F and an R and an E and a D and an F-R-E-D, Fred. Yeah.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She wrestles like a Greek. You will clap your hands in wonder at her fabulous technique. I'm in love with a girl named Fred, who dances with such grace. You are bound to sing her praises till you're purple in the face.
Bravo, bravissimo, bravo, bravissimo. Fill the bowl to overflowing, raise the goblet high. With an F and an R and E and a D and F-R-E-D, Fred.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She's musical to boot. She will set your feet a-tapping when she plays upon her lute.
Bravo, bravo, bravissimo, bravo, bravissimo. Fill the bowl to overflowing, raise the goblet high.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred, a clever clownish wit. When she does her funny pantomime, your sides are sure to split.
Bravo, bravo, bravissimo, bravo, bravissimo.
Girl,
with a girl
named F-R-E-D.
quiet!
Quiet. The queen insists on quiet. She's ordered 20 mattresses, the softest and the best. And she's threatened execution if we dare disturb the rest of her very special guest. She's ordered quiet.
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 The queen insists
the
on
queen
quiet.
Insists on she's quiet.
Ordered 20 she's mattresses, ordered 20 the mattresses, and the softest, and she's threatened execution. Execution if we dare disturb the rest of her very special guest.
She's ordered quiet.
The queen insists on quiet.
Insists on queen insists on quiet.
20 mattresses, and the mattress, and she's threatened execution. Execution if we dare disturb her very special guest.
Quiet, 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 quiet.
Shh.
Sheets?
Right.
Pillows?
Right.
Blankets?
Right.
Mattresses?
Right, right, right. Right.
Not yet. I'll distract the queen. You take care of them.
Minstrel! Somebody stop her, I say! There she goes, just down that corridor! Somebody bring her here to me! Now, this is a fine kettle of fish, you wretch! I want the truth! Every time I turn my back, something outrageous!
Never mind me!
Harry!
Get these out of here, get these out of here.
I want the truth. What is going on around here? Oh, what are you up to? What? What is going on around here? What's under the mattress? Oh, it's a dead body. Oh. We'll pull that away. Oh. Well. What is going on around here? Explain yourself.
It's just a joke, Your Majesty.
Yeah.
This boy and I go outside and wait for me, Lancelot. That's not a bow.
Lancelot, wait. Lady Larken! Oh! Go take those things up to what's-her-name's chamber and mattresses, too.
But Your Majesty...
Quiet! What are you doing in that ridiculous getup?
Please, I...
Silence! And why weren't you at the ball?
Your Majesty...
Shut up! And what are you doing with this man? Answer me!
Your Majesty...
Well, speak up!
Your Majesty, I beg of you...
You were running away, is that it? You were running away!
Larken!
Why, you low-born, ungrateful little sneak! Is this the thanks I get for treating you as my own daughter? Just look at you! One of my girls running off with a jester? Really?
Lady Larken is innocent! I tell you the truth. She was forced to leave against her will.
That's not true!
Why?
Just a moment!
Larken! What are you doing with that man?
What are you doing with that woman?
Just a moment!
You go to your room.
Don't you tell me what to do, you liberty!
Quiet! are still one of my ladies-in-waiting, get above the stairs where you belong and prepare what's-her-name for bed.
Could you imagine?
Do as I say. And may I remind you, Sir Harry, that you are still one of my knights? Step forward. And you relax, okay? Sir Harry, I order this minstrel banished from my kingdom. Why? I want her gone by daybreak. Oh, I can. Sextimus! Go to bed. I don't want you groping around in the dark all night. And as for the rest of you, there is a little girl upstairs who is dog tired.
Oh, no, she said she was going to study for her test.
All right, we'll let her study. But when she is ready for bed, I want her to get a good night's rest. So I want quiet around here. Is that clear? I want quiet, and I am going to get quiet if I have to scream the palace down!
Yes!
Quiet!
Quiet. The queen insists on quiet. The queen insists, the queen insists, the queen insists on quiet!
Shh!
Next one is sum.
Easy. Sum. S-U-M, sum.
Summer.
Summer. S-U-M-E-R, summer.
Good. Well, if Mama tests you in literature spelling, you're sure to pass, Fred.
Oh, yes!
That leaves, history.
Oh, history. Well, that takes in quite a lot, but let's give it a whirl.
The first chapter is called The Bravery of Prince Waldir.
Waldir,
Prince Waldir, wishing to slay the dragon Fafnir.
Who?
Wishing to slay the dragon Fafnir.
Oh yeah, Fafnir.
Takes his father's sword, Minning.
Minning?
Disguised as the West Wind, he goes in the forest and surprises Fafnir in his lair and slays him, whereupon he is enabled to understand the speech of the birds. Meanwhile, Waldir's father, Albrecht, disguised as a sacred goat, tells him that the spirit of Gunthir is going to...
Gunthir? But, did you ring for a page boy?
No.
Well, you got the wrong room. Oh, wait a minute. Aren't you Larken?
Yes, Your Highness.
Well, what's the matter?
Wait a second. I have a suit just like that.
I'm in disguise, Your Highness. I was running away.
I see. Well, take a seat.
Oh, but the queen has
ordered. Never mind what the queen has ordered. Just sit here. Now, what is this all about?
I'll just go out on the parapet, stand there naked, catch a chill, and die. That'll show him.
Show him what?
He'll be sorry.
Who?
Horrible Harry.
You mean big nice Harry?
Oh, just a minute. What did you do to him?
What did I do to him?
Well, you must have done something. You're acting the way I did once when I was afraid to go home because I'd given my little brother a bloody lip. Oh, it was an accident.
We had a disagreement.
So you decided to run away?
Well, he said some perfectly horrible things to me.
Oh, I see. Well, in that case, I guess you're right. I guess about the only thing you can do is pack up and get out. Unless, of course, you just go to him and say you're sorry. Listen, that Harry is a wonderful boy, and he really loves you. Why, we were on the road for 2 weeks, and he never laid a finger on me!
Oh, Your Highness?
Now, Larken, just get into something pretty that shows you're a girl. And try and act a little helpless. Men don't like girls that are too strong.
Oh, well... I do.
Oh. dear princess, how will I ever thank you? If it's a girl, I'm going to name her Fred.
Well, but what if it's a boy?
Oh, Dauntless, you better go on to bed and leave the history book.
Well, I'm certain you're going to pass the test tomorrow. Well, at least I'm pretty sure.
Well, if you don't, I'll understand.
And so the young prince, Waldair, having slain the dragon Fafnir, with the sword Minning, rescued the princess Frigga, and together they mounted his horse Trigga. Frigga, Trigga. That's so stupid. And rode to the castle Vundabar, where they were married and lived happily ever after.
Well, I'm glad.
They all lived happily, happily, happily ever after. The couple is happily leaving the chapel eternally tied. As the curtain descends, there is nothing but loving and laughter. When the fairy tale ends, the heroine's always a bride. Ella, the girl of the cinders, did the wash on the walls and the winders, but she landed a prince who was brawny and blue-eyed and blonde. Still, I honestly doubt that she could ever have done it without that crazy lady with the wand. Cinderella had outside help. I have no one but me. Fairy godmother, 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 where can you be? I don't even have a fairy godmother. I don't even have a godmother. I have a mother, a plain, ordinary woman. Snow White was so pretty, they tell us, that the queen was insulted and jealous when the mirror declared that Snow White was the fairest of all. She was dumped on the border, but was saved by some men who adored her. Oh, I grant you. They were small, but there were 7 of them, practically a regiment. I'm alone in the night, by myself, not a dwarf, not an elf, not a goblin in sight. That girl had 7 determined little men working day and night just for her. Oh, sure, the queen gave her a poison apple. Even so, she lived happily, happily, happily ever after. A magical kiss counteracted the apple eventually. Though I know I'm not clever, I'll do what they tell me I have to. I want some happily ever after to happen to me. Rapunzel had platinum dresses that were double the length of her tresses. She was kept in the tower for years by a wicked old witch. Till one night in despair down, she scrambled by letting her hair down. That's what I call quite the switch. I wonder. Never hold. I'll be finished before I begin. And besides, I don't want to get out. I want to get in. I want to live happily, happily, happily ever after. I want to walk happily out of the chapel eternally tied. Before I know, I will never live happily ever after. Till after. Thoroughly satisfied. a tyrant. Just because you won your spurs, you
Now see here. This man has been charged with attempting to transport a young woman out of kingdom against her will. That's a serious offense.
He didn't do it. It was a frame-up.
You've got it all wrong.
He was protecting the Lady Larken, and you stay out of this, Your Majesty.
Sir Harry, I can't leave yet. There's someone I need to see first.
Who?
The wizard. I want your permission to speak to the wizard.
Yes.
No. Permission denied.
Sir Harry, you're a fathead.
Yes, you are. Can't you tell I'm trying to help? We're all just trying to help.
How can you help?
By finding out what the test is from the wizard.
That's cheating.
Don't you understand? This is for you.
Let us go to the wizard.
No. If anyone should defy the wizard's magic, I should.
You need to stand guard. This is my job. No, you might get hurt. You can't come, and that's final. Really? This is you want to do this now? All right.
What's the matter, Papa?
The king mustn't come with us.
I'll get rid of him. Your Majesty, I think it's time for you and Dauntless to have that little talk now.
Oh, maybe some other time.
No, Dauntless. It's very important.
It is?
It can't be put off. Do your duty, sire.
What do you want to talk to me about, Papa? Huh? What's the matter? What's this man-to-man stuff? Stop. Look. Listen, little prince. Boy. Flower. Girl. Flower. Boy, flower, girl, flower. Oh, tell me more. I want to know about what getting married is for. Seed fall from girl flower, and by baby flower grow. Oh, but why? Oh, tell me why. Oh, father, tell me, father, don't be shy. Boy flower, girl flower, love each other. Boy flower, father, girl flower, mother. Yes, yes, but how? It's very interesting. Oh, how? Oh, tell me now. On boy flower, boy flower, dust. Ha, gets on bee. Bee flies to girl flower. Dust touches girl flower. Oh, I see. No, I don't see. It's very interesting, but still not clear to me. Woman is like girl flower, and man is like bee. And boy flower, man, that's me. Oh, tell me more. I want to know about what getting married is for. Carrie. Oh, sounds like Carrie. Dairy. Harry. Mary. Man and woman get married. Winifred and White. Love each other. Night. 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 And then one night. Yes, yes, one night. It's very interesting what happens in the night. What happens? What happens? Oh, father, tell me, please. Shall I go and pick some flowers? Shall I go and catch some bees? Princess Winifred and I will get married. Night, night, and then one night. The stork? The stork will come and bring us a baby. Oh, Papa, I know all about the stork. Mama told me about the years.
Wait a minute, Papa.
Flower, seed, man, woman, bee, baby, small. It isn't the stork, it isn't the stork, it isn't the stork at all. Oh, life is grand, it's very interesting. I think I understand, I think I know. It's very interesting. Thank you, Father, and Father, I love you.
Pardon me, Sir Wizard.
What do you want?
The minstrel is a great admirer of yours.
No soft soap, if you please.
Oh, this isn't soft soap. And I wouldn't say anything except for the fact that I've been banished. And before I go, well, I hope this doesn't embarrass you, but I just wanted to tell you what a great artist you are, Cardamon.
Cardamon? Don't call me by that name.
I use that name with great honor, sir. I don't think I'll ever forget seeing you in command performance in Glastonbury 92. What a show! What a triumph! You took 7 curtain calls that night.
8 curtain calls.
I don't suppose you remember a little girl in the second row who stood up and yelled bravo that night.
Yes.
I was that little girl.
I don't believe it.
Yes, and if it means anything to you, I'm in show business now too. And it was your doing that brought this about.
You must belong to the guild.
To think
that people still remember those days.
Yes, well, I better be on my way.
No, stay a while.
Oh,
for you.
Thank you so much.
Here, have a seat.
Oh, no, I don't think the queen would like it if she knew I was still here.
Never mind her. This is between us. Sit. Thank you.
I bet you're pretty busy getting ready for that test.
Oh, don't worry about that. The test is all taken care of.
I don't suppose you could tell an old guild member what the test is about.
Well, I'm sort of under an oath.
Oh, it's okay. I better be going.
No, stay. Can I borrow your handkerchief?
What handkerchief? Oh, wow! Cardamon the Great! Wow!
I bet some say my act is pretty foul.
Oh, wow.
I bet you can't guess what the test is about.
Astronomy.
No, you'll never guess. It's sensitivity.
Oh, wow! Cardamon the Great.
Cardamon the Great Est. Now, I'll tell you about the rest of the test. No. Never mind, I shouldn't.
I'll go. But before I do, Cardamon, may I take these?
What do you want with them?
A memento of the good old days, because of my father.
Keep it.
Thank you.
Oh, Jester.
Thank you, sir.
That was a very nice thing you did for that boy, Cardamon.
Well, for his father's sake.
Hey, I don't actually have to be out of here until daybreak. Why don't we go down to the wine cellar, split a bottle, and finish talking about the finish talking.
Well, I've sort of started something here, and I'd want to finish it, but I'll be down there in 2 seconds.
I'll be waiting.
Jester.
Ooh.
What's the matter, Jester?
Nothing.
Well, say something funny, come on.
Yes.
Have you ever heard of my father, Sliding Peter Jingle?
Is that funny? Okay, yeah, let's get out of here.
Is that not funny?
Okay, I think the clown is losing his touch.
I am far from sentimental or romantic, and I like to think I'm strictly up to date. But at times the dancing gets a bit too frantic in these hectic days of 1428. So indulge me as I pause to raise my chalice to a quaint and charming dance they used to do in the days when my dear father played the palace back in 1392. My dad was debonair and quite as light as air. In his very soft shoes, how he could dip and glide and skip and slip and slide. In his very soft shoes, I used to stand and watch him every day. He was always smooth and cool. I used to love to hear the people say he's a regular dancing fool. He barely touched the ground and never made a sound. But I noticed in all his reviews that when he took his bow to the crowd and the crown, the crowd went crazy and the house came down when Dad wore his very soft shoes.
Yesterday I loved you as never before, but please don't think me strange. I've undergone a change, and today I love you. I love you less than I will tomorrow.
Yesterday I loved you as never before,
as lovely to me as anyone ever could be. Now I see what tricks my eyes can play. Yesterday, I must have been utterly blind, or else I was out of my mind, for I find you so much lovelier today.
My heart cannot be trusted, I give you fair warning,
for yesterday I loved you as never before, but that was long ago. And now it's best to know that today I love you even more. My heart cannot be trusted, I give you fair warning, I openly confess, tonight I love you less than I will tomorrow.
All the way up the most killing steps in the kingdom. Yes. Yes. Oh, it's so cute and tiny. All right, you can come in now. Did you bring everything? Ah, the hypnotic mirror.
Yes, madam.
And the rest of the things.
Yes, madam.
And the girl? Where's the girl? Doesn't she know it is well past her bedtime? You would think she would be dropping from there you are. Ready for bed? Uh-huh. You should be sure to get a good night's rest so you'll be fresh early for your journey back to your kingdom or wherever you're going. The hypnotic mirror. And the incantation, the wizard said it would be written on...
Here it is, Your Majesty.
Yes. Mm-mm. Silken, swishing sibilance wraps us in a gentle trance. Deep in Morpheus's arms we lie. Off we go to Betty Bye.
You know, I think I'm getting a star right there.
Bring on the poppy and mandragora incense.
Ooh.
Drowsy incense, sweet aroma, wraps us in a gentle coma. Murmuring voices seem to say, Mr. Sandman's on his way. That ought to get us to sleep, shouldn't it? the sleeping draft.
Here, madam.
Yes. Drink a little extract of opium and warm milk before going to bed. I always say, drink it down. Now, to make sure that you have no trouble drifting off, I've prepared a special treat. Bring on the Nightingale of Samarkand.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
Where's the Nightingale of Samarkand? Naturally, I have to do everything myself.
Oh, pretty bird.
Oh, it's so pretty.
Oh, my gosh.
All right, sing! Stop! You were brought to put a live princess to sleep, not wake a dead one. Let's have a lullaby, birdie. Nice and soft.
castle is going to get a good night's rest,
please. Fix it?
Leave me alone, Mama. I can dress myself.
Well, far be it from me to interfere, my dear.
I can do it.
Well, what are you wearing that so early in the morning for?
Well, the test is today, Mama, and I want to look my best for...
Oh, the test? Oh, why, the test is over, honey.
Huh?
The test is over, darling boy.
When was it? What was it?
Oh, it was last night. We put her to sleep on 20 soft, downy mattresses with a pea under the bottom one to test her sensitivity. Oh, of course, the pea would have kept any real princess awake.
And she slept?
Well, I'm sure, I don't know, but she was practically falling asleep before she even got into bed and yawning like a vulgar scullery maid. She looked ghastly, darling, and old enough to be your... Well, we'll see.
Oh, Fred.
I'm sorry, I'm so nervous, I can't help it. I could die, absolutely die.
Enjoy yourselves. They'll be here in a minute.
If she didn't pass, I'm leaving.
Don't talk. Here comes the queen.
And someday, dear, we'll find you a real princess, so don't worry. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, Your Majesty.
Off to see our little princess on her way, since she is such a favorite of ours. I thought she should have an extra special consolation prize. Sir Studley,
Here, Your Majesty, a very thoughtful gift.
Charming! Charming!
Isn't it sweet?
Dauntless, no, bad boy! Such a bad boy!
Now where is our little slug a bed? She should be getting an early start. Oh, there she is, and she isn't even dressed yet. She must have slept like a baby.
37,428.
37,428 what?
Sheep! What do you stuff your mattresses with? Jousting equipment?
What do you mean?
I mean that bed. Oh, that bed ought to be moved down to the torture chamber.
You didn't sleep?
I never shut my eyes.
You passed.
Passed what?
The test. Mama put a pee under 20 mattresses, and you felt it, and now we can be married.
A pee under 20 mattresses. Well, no wonder why I'm so black and blue.
Now, don't you think she's pretty?
She's not pretty. She's beautiful.
Oh. 20 mattresses, huh? Dauntless, dear. I'll leave the wedding arrangements up to you. You better start looking around for a small kingdom for us. I have got a feeling we are not gonna want to live with the in-laws.
Well, she's gonna get cold sleeping there on that bare floor. I better take her up to our room.
Dauntless! Wait!
What should I wait for, Mama?
To give this matter proper consideration.
Well, she passed the test, and now we'll take her up to our room.
I said wait! Now through this whole heartbreaking business of finding you a true princess, I've never nagged, never interfered, never expected one solitary word of sympathy.
Mama, she's sleeping.
But I will not allow you to throw yourself away on this little nobody.
Mama, quiet.
She may have passed the test, but I must say I have never trusted anyone with those shifty eyes and that mean
mouth. I said to shut up!
Oh. It happened. The prophecy. The mouse devoured the hawk.
Look. Look, the queen can't talk.
I can.
The king speaks.
And I have a lot to say.
Well, good night.
Unhand the boy. You can go now, son. Now, you've done diddly asked for it, Agravain, and you are gonna get it. So, when I say hop, I want you to hop. Go on now. Hop. I'm waiting.
That's
skip. Oh yeah. Jump. Hop. Skip. Jump.
How did she sail away? That pier was awfully small.
It wasn't the pee
at all. Oh, life is grand, it's grand.